350 horsepower Maverick R with pops and bangs, with launch control. Still got the cobble job exhaust on it. We got a couple hours to kill this afternoon, and it's a beautiful day. So we just thought we'll get that thing out and give it a little rip.
Finally nice in Michigan for a little bit.
And then, you know, Mike, in true Mike fashion, says, hey, you want me to bring Big Dog and drag race it? He's always just bullying.
He's riding high now after picking on Joey.
After his win versus Joey, he's riding high. He's looking, you know, he's looking to drag race everything, and he's picking on a poor Maverick R, dude. Unreal.
I started that, and then it evolved into, I didn't think people were probably going to take it, and then somehow this.
So he said, yeah. You know,
also showed.
Right. Like, you know, if we're going to get fast stuff out, then maybe we'll just see what this is like. Big Dog versus Hell Force? I don't think we've seen that action yet.
No. It's just a nice day. Like, we really wanted to come out and see what the new tunes on the Maverick R were like. We wanted to get some 60-foot times, check all that out, see how the power delivery is, and get some room on it. And why not just bring a few more extra toys to have some fun with, so.
Yeah, so Hell Force is paddled up. We'll save that for a little bit later. I think first order of business is get this Maverick R out and, like, really experience it with this new tune on E85 with that fresh Evo horsepower. Mm-hmm. Just rip it around. Maybe we'll do some 0 to 60s on it. And
I
then
just want to try the launch control for real.
Yeah, so, in the dirt.
So at 5,200.
I think we can bump it up to 5,200 RPM launch.
Okay.
So it'll probably just spin a lot, but we'll find out.
I like that. Cool, so. That's all that really matters. All we're really trying to do here is be cool.
Okay, wow. It makes pretty good noise out.
Listen, the decel popping is so enjoyable. I don't care what anybody says. I love the decel pops. It's so fun.
Yeah, and it'll be, like, it's a little much with the straight pipe, but
yeah,
with a real exhaust, it's going to be incredible.
Just
so much fun.
Enjoyable. Mm-hmm. All right, so do you feel like did you get a feel for it yet, or are you just warming it up?
I might do a little bit more. I was just in Sport, not Sport Plus.
Oh, okay. Let's hear Sport Plus in this thing.
Okay.
You know, get some good heat in her, and
I'll try to keep her a little bit closer by.
Okay.
We'll see.
Okay.
All right.
It looks pretty fast, boys.
It actually looks really fast.
Wow. Yeah. Woo! Man, that little tip-in sound, too, when he retaps the throttle. Excellent. I love that shot. This machine has got a lot of character now. Makes crazy sounds, it looks fast. The chassis just moves all over under braking and acceleration. Matt, this
Wow, so that's, I hit 90 miles an hour when I passed you guys.
Really?
That wasn't even from that was like halfway down the field.
It looks fast.
Whew.
It looks fast doing everything. When you're drifting that corner down there,
yeah,
it looks awesome.
Man.
You think you can get 100
from
the very end?
It's still so controlled, too. But
is that the challenge of the day? See if we can get it to 100 miles in the field? Could be.
You know, don't hurt yourself, but yeah, it'd be cool to see, you know, just feel it out, just kind of tiptoe it.
This thing does have really good brakes. Like, the pedal feel is not good,
yep,
but it does haul it down.
But it does stop.
Pretty well. Yeah, I'll go back there and launch it and see how fast we can
just
go.
Just see what you can get for a number out of curiosity. Oh boy, here we go. 5,200 RPM launch. First real nasty launch with this tune and this machine. Oh, wow. All right, sorry for yelling, but that was pretty intense.
She ain't slow.
That's such a nasty launch for a machine that just has a fuel pump and a tune in it.
Dude, the transmission gear shifting sounded excellent.
Yeah.
Like, it just grabbed every gear so nicely going all the way through.
We need to convince it to hold it for like 2 more seconds.
for. I think he was just feeling it out there.
He blew his gas door open.
Matt, you went so fast, you blew the gas door open.
Whew. Yeah, she blew the door open.
Wow, that.
Matt,
really
that seemed.
That's fast.
It looks fast. That launch control is intense when it comes on.
It is. It is. It launches a lot like an X3. You know. That's dialed in.
She moves out.
I still hit like 90, 92.
Okay.
But I wussed out.
I mean,
I could have run it a lot longer. I underestimated how fast I could stop.
Right.
So
last thing you want to do is crash into the railroad tracks back there. So
right.
So what you're saying is you should do that one more time?
I think I'll do it one more time.
I could watch at least a couple more launches. I don't really care how far you go.
Well,
0 to 60. Wow.
4.22, right?
4.22 seconds.
Verified.
That takes us to the point where we're a full second faster than stock.
Yeah, wasn't it 5.2? Yeah.
It started at 5.2. When we tuned it initially on the pump gas tune, we got down into the 480s. Now we're into the 420s on the first hit. On a tire setup, that is not a drag race setup whatsoever. So, I mean, there's a lot left on the table with this thing with a lighter, more aggressive tire.
Man, that's legitimately fast.
That's ripping.
Holy moly.
That's ripping. Big Dog's probably in trouble, dude. I'm calling it. I think Big Dog's going down.
Come on.
I think he is.
Let's see a couple more launches with this thing.
Oh.
All right, we're going to give this sucker another hit. We're really leaning into the launch control this time. Just let her. I mean, that machine is ripping.
That thing has fully embraced the rally car life.
On stock tires, big heavy machine, like, that's impressive. That is impressive.
Like, I will bet you right now that thing's gotta have, what, 500 pounds on mine?
That gas door is not happy, but the rest of the machine is happy. Oh, I see what happened here. All right, we can fix that. Matt, that was, I will say that when it sat on launch control a little bit longer, it did make a different tone after the first second.
It did. I don't know if that was better or worse.
I don't know either.
I heard it popping at the top of every shift. Like, it go into the next shift, you hear it, pow, like.
Yeah.
And just a reminder for everybody who didn't watch the previous video when we did this work, the launch control is still in beta mode. This is a beta test tune on that, so you know it's just gonna get better. But
all right, so still verified, did a little bit worse.
Okay.
4.32.
okay,
which is still in the realm of like proving it out,
still
like,
fast. So wow. Maybe it doesn't need to sit on the launch control that long, but regardless, it's ripping.
It's still running a 499 and 300 foot and crap tires and crap condition.
Yeah, this thing on like, paddles on a good track,
yep,
is gonna run, you know, high fours all the time
easily,
and that's crazy.
Yeah,
easily. That's fast. Well,
it's very fast.
What are you pointing that camera this way for, Douglas?
Michael. I mean, obviously we know it looks fast. We got Big Dog. Big Dog is very, very fast. We're talking big turbo.
Right. So we're to the X3. Point we know and we're sure, unless something bad happens, what to expect out of this. But like 400 or 500 pounds heavier. That thing has got like literally a full drag clutch setup in it right now. Big turbo, expensive clutch, bigger injectors, better intercooler, like a ton of stuff. This is just tuned with a fuel swap.
Fuel pump.
Sorry. Well, yeah, fuel pump and fuel swap.
Fuel swap.
And
that's it.
Yeah.
So that's our point. Like, let's just see what this thing has.
Pretty basic mods on a Maverick R versus what is essentially like a drag/dune.
Unless I turn it down and change the clutching, X3. It's basically set up for drag racing right now.
So. All right, let's touch them off and see how this thing can hang.
Yeah.
I mean, Big Dog's fast. Big Dog's fast. All right, 350 horsepower, E85 Maverick R versus Big Dog. All right, you know, Big Dog, really fast.
Yeah, pretty much to be expected, honestly.
Not surprising.
A cool comparison for, you know, basically a stock Maverick R with, like we said, you know, fuel pump tune.
Yeah, I mean, if we had any, like, average machines out here, both of those rigs would blow it away, so.
Big Dog is probably a thousand. Big Dog's probably 1,000 pounds lighter almost.
Yeah.
Than that car.
Yeah, I mean,
so that's air shocks right now too. I mean,
that machine rips. We have our race events. It's consistently winning a lot of races against built rigs. Okay, run number two. Oh boy. Man. The old Mav R hung in there pretty dang well.
Not bad.
I mean,
not bad for a car that can go eat whoops at 90 miles an hour right after this.
Seriously, impressive.
Oh,
wow.
It just looks so fun.
It's so fast.
The brakes were good.
It does stop in a hurry. That was a good race.
That was a real solid race.
I mean, obviously, okay, Big Dog is faster.
Still just faster.
It's a very fast machine, but
this thing is also fast.
It was, that was respectable.
Yeah, that was respectable. Like, when I looked back in my mirror, I was looking, I'm like, oh, Steve's not that far back.
It wasn't. It wasn't bus lengths. Mm-hmm. Wasn't bus lengths.
Yeah,
Maverick.
A couple lengths, I think at most, probably.
Yeah, this ripping. Thing's gonna hurt some feelings, I think.
It's gonna surprise people.
It's very
gonna,
surprising.
On the drag strip with some paddles. We'll see that action soon enough at race day coming.
Yeah,
May 11th.
Somewhere back
lighting's,
off-road.
Lighting's bad. I'm gonna move around
all right,
here.
All
right. All right, hit that promo, Mike.
Hold on, lighting's bad. Let me put these on real quick. Whew. May 11th. Silverback Off-Road Speedway, you guys. We're having a race day event. We've been talking about this. We're keep pounding this in until the day comes. It's coming. You guys need to be there. It's a ton of fun. Spectators are free. Outlaw, bracket, short course, long jump. Come on out, have a good time.
Just
have some fun.
Big old party.
Yeah. If any of you guys are wanting to set up vendors or anything like that or help out with the event, get a hold of us at raceday2024@gmail.com if you're interested at all.
Oh, yeah.
If not, like I said, come on out and have a good time with the rest of us.
Mears, Michigan. It's the place to be. Silverback Off-Road Speedway.
Yep. The dunes are right around the corner, too.
Yeah, you can go dune riding if you want. See this thing race. Maybe we need to see it race again right now.
Oof, I know what that means.
Because we do still have another competitor. You are the winner of round one. So, I mean, we'll let it cool off a little bit, but I think it's time. Big Dog versus Hellforce.
That's fast.
Yeah, you barely beat a Maverick R, dude. How are you going to beat Hellforce?
Between you and Matt today, I'm done.
All right, now straight up, really though, okay, Hellforce. If you guys don't know Hellforce, this machine was built specifically for burnout contests, right? 800 horsepower, Dodge Demon engine in it. It's got a Mustang S650 rear subframe, Power Glide transmission. Since it was built for burnout contests, it was built to make enormous amounts of wheel speed, make about 160 miles an hour of wheel speed, which means it's geared incredibly too high for drag racing in short distances.
You want to see something do 100 mile an hour on this property in first gear.
Yeah.
It's going to be that.
So 800 horsepower, yes, but also not geared correctly for drag racing. So in a shorter distance, it's not that fast. Like this thing versus Big Dog.
Could be interesting.
Could be an interesting race. So
I think the only thing saving me is my launch control. Right?
Yeah, I think this will reel
how'd
it
you,
in.
How'd you say it? 60-foot mic?
Yeah, honestly, I think you're definitely going to get him out of the hole. Well, then again, I don't know, because the paddles could be huge here.
The paddles could
this
work.
This is a big question mark. It could really go either way.
Don't really know what's going to happen. I'll tell you what could definitely happen with those street tires on the front.
Slicks.
Is we could just skate for 7 miles
and
crash.
Much stopping power, so keep that in mind.
It's been
a long time since I've seen somebody send it almost to the train tracks out here.
Well,
let's not do that today, but I'm just saying.
Probably see it here shortly. All right.
All right, we got Hellforce. We got Michael. We got Matthew doing the flagging. This could really go either way.
I heard some clunk in there.
I heard some not super happy noises.
Mike! No!
Yeah.
Come here!
What?
No!
Oh my god!
That's half of his front diff.
Dude, get Visco locked.
Oh, wow. Oh no!
Yeah, it was violent.
Mike!
I heard that one. That was
fine. Oh gosh, we gotta look at the rest of it. Oh! Holy crap!
Oh!
Holy crap!
We got some work to do, Mike.
Oh no! We got some work to do.
You don't even know.
Oh, man!
His Visco lock went Visco unlock.
When I see a piece of it. Is that a piece of it?
That is a piece of the Visco.
Did he get the dirt?
Wow. I have not seen that before.
Well, here's half of his front diff.
Wow.
I've never seen a Visco lock explode.
I just assumed it was another axle shaft and, well, at least I can get that one.
Holy smokes.
Look at that in there, dude. I mean, it's a little just...
Take a look, Doug.
I mean, it just puked the whole thing. It just exploded.
The pinion just exited the diff. Pinion's like, I'm out of here, bud. I'm done with this. This is too much stress. I've rotated too many times. Hellforce got the launch on me. I'm out of here. I'm done.
These 32-inch Terra hooks are your worst nightmare.
They are so far. I mean, also, the car has like 2,300 miles of probably half a billion hole shots on it.
That's like Hall of Fame level carnage. You can't even be mad about that.
I'm not. I'm actually just like in shock that it kicked it out the rear and...
Pinion gear, more like pin out gear, you know what I'm saying? I can't
stop. You need to stop.
Pinion, more like pinion.
Yeah, I felt really stupid because I was talking about how close the race is going to be, and then you were just like three car lengths out instantly. I was like, well, all right, that's not how that was supposed to go.
Well, sorry, man.
The car has been so good to me for years, and this year just falling right apart now.
I'm gonna make quick 0-60 hit in this, and maybe we just rip that Maverick car around a little bit more.
Yeah, I would enjoy that.
Big dog's big done, so.
Big done.
It's a real kick in the diff.
Big done.
Draggy, datums, we gotta see it.
I'm just curious. I don't recall if we've ever gotten a 0-60 time on this machine.
I don't think so either. I mean, the only time would be when we've ran it at Silverback, but I don't know. You don't get 0-60s.
Yeah, we didn't have draggy on it any of those times. And honestly, I think it's hooking out here quite a bit harder. The dirt's just a little bit soft because we've gotten some rain. So I think it's a primo time to just see what this thing's got in at 0-60 on the dirt.
I'm going to say it's going to do 397.
I got 336.
336?
336. That's
holy
smoking
moly.
Fast.
I'll go 386.
Look at that thing. It looks so unnatural out here.
You mean like my broke car you asked me to move?
No, that looks very natural. All right, let's see that 0-60 time.
Whoa!
What the heck?
It looks like it wants to pull a wheelie.
That thing is not... No, it's faster out here than it was in our field.
Yeah, I think so.
I think it's faster here than it was at Silver Lake. Like, that looked rowdy. Rowdy.
Oh, this is definitely faster than Silverback. Dirt compared to sand? Absolutely.
Yeah, it's never looked like that.
Jesus. It seems like it's really, like, lighting up.
Brother.
That lane was a little rough. I moved left to try to get further away from you guys, and she did a little hop there in the middle, but...
It looked like it wanted to pull the wheels off the ground.
It felt still pretty good.
It looked rowdy.
We got a 0-60, 3.32 seconds.
No way! That's awesome!
3.32.
What did I say?
Do you have more? Like, did you run out 300 feet?
I don't know if I got the 300 feet or not.
Sure looked like it ran a long ways.
It came by us at a rate of speed that
it was motoring, dude.
Unprecedented.
I did run at 300 feet. It went 443. So,
pretty good.
443?
443.
That's very
that was
good.
Cool. It was a really cool watch.
Cool car.
Very cool.
Cool car. All right, we gotta drive this Maverick car some more.
Yeah, you guys experience that thing.
I'm excited to experience this thing. It's time.
all this horsepower, all these sounds.
Just see what it feels like, you know? She sounds great.
Still in my mind trying to figure out what that sounds like exactly.
Sounds like a modern rally car. The thing about that thing is it feels like the acceleration is so consistent. Like it feels like it will go 200 miles an hour. Is he going in the ditch?
No, there's not a ditch back there.
Oh.
Oh, I think he's seriously how fast he's
going. 300.
Oh my god.
Okay,
you're
doing pretty good.
That thing stops so quick.
I know, it does.
It looks like he just stayed in for another 20 feet.
Look at that. Just massive amounts of speed.
So nice.
Just trying to help. Man, listen to those pops
four,
on the upshifts.
Five.
I wish I could see more of that, but holy crap. Basically just sliding for 100 feet.
This thing rips.
Hey, man.
It rips. Like, it's pretty intense with the exhaust. The exhaust is definitely too much, which obviously we've covered that. It's just a joke. It's not staying on the car. But it's an intense experience.
Yeah.
The shifts and the sounds, this is really cool. This is really cool.
How fast did you get?
96.
Yep.
Okay.
I think I could get 100 out of it if we wanted to be really silly. I don't know if the juice is worth the squeeze just to say we did it.
Probably not.
But.
Yeah, and doesn't it feel like it's got like an infinite top end?
Yeah.
It just pulls and pulls and pulls and pulls.
It does just keep pulling. It doesn't, yeah, that's a good way to describe it. It stays flat. The acceleration is really smooth all the way to the top. And, you know, maybe that's a DCT thing. As you get in the upper gears, you're not really losing additional efficiency through the transmission. It just keeps going. Cool car, man. Cool car.
You didn't even tap seventh gear. I think you only hit it sixth, and that was it.
Yeah, I wasn't really paying attention to that.
I was listening to your going. It sounded like you just hit sixth, and you had to dive out or so.
Heck yeah, boys.
Yeah, pretty cool. Cool car. Maverick R. Would, at this point, recommend doing some mods if you're going to get one of these things. I think we're going to call it a day. Mike's already done literal tens of thousands of dollars of damage to his machine.
Hundreds of thousands of dollars.
Hundreds of thousands.
Let's not break
dollars.
Anything else while I'm at it.
He's never going to
financially recover from this.
Yeah, never going to recover from this. Good day, though. Sun's shining. Finally, it's feeling like we're close to decent enough weather to get back outdoors. So that's a cool thing. And then, until next time, we'll see you guys. Thank you for being with us again, doing everything you do to support us by continuing to watch these videos and subscribing and donating on Patreon, buying those parts, like all of it. Buying through that Rocky Mountain link. Just thank you guys so much. We'll be back, hopefully with a fixed big dog.
Maybe.
Question mark?
I think so. I'm sure we'll fix it, but yeah. Stay tuned till next time, and yeah.
Let's not forget the dunes are opening.
Soon.
Imminently.
Yeah, next week.
And we have to be dunes. Over there.
Yeah.
Open.
If with this.
If the weather would cooperate a little more, it'd be nice, but we'll still make it work.
It'll cooperate.
See you guys.